up the YouTube, it's your boy Red Chaos One. Guess who's back?
Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back.
I know that it has been a while since I posted a video, and I'm sorry, but I just needed a little break from all the web novels and the YouTubing, you know, just to avoid being a burnt-out husk on my chair. Now, if you're a returning viewer, then you obviously know what you're in for. But if you're not, then welcome to the premier web novel channel on YouTube. If you want to read this book yourselves, you will find the link to it below in my description. Alongside a link to my story, Phantom Drake, which is an action high fantasy that isn't your generic medieval fantasy story. It has cool sci-fi elements and action scenes straight out of the Japanime for all you weeaboos out there. Also, please remember to subscribe and to hit that bell icon to be notified about future videos. And also to help smoothen my soft, fragile ego. Our story comes from webnovel.com. You know, these guys. It is called The Pig of Axias. And it was written by Kyle, who is on my Discord. Now, if you didn't know, I got a Discord. And if you're interested in meeting them, seeing, discussing, finding a place to talk about web novels, then you can come check out my Discord, which has an invitation in the description below as well. And yes, I am shilling out my Discord, why you ask? But before we continue, we need to go through this book synopsis in order to give you guys a better view of the story, because my usual incoherent rambling isn't good enough to paint you a picture. Now, on that day, Bartholomew could see everything on the execution grounds. The man who had one day betrayed his own kingdom was getting executed, and so the gallant prince would lead the empire. After years of suffering, the prince of the now fallen kingdom came back and released the people from the hands of the evil Krisnov Empire, taking back his rightful lands, imprisoning the traitors of his former kingdom, and conquering the wretched empire. His tales would certainly be passed to generations, forever being remembered. It's just like a folk tale. The story was a beautiful yet simple one. There was just one problem to this story. Bartholomew was the one being executed. And this, kids, is what is called not your typical fantasy. It's not your farm boy, chosen one, leaving his home after his mentor gets killed to go fight the demon lord. No, no, no. This story doesn't fall into those bad usual fantasy trappings. It is a well-written story with great character interactions, especially exemplified in the first chapters with the relationship of Bartholomew and Ventrion. Their relationship you initially expect to be extremely an antagonistic one, since one is a traitor and another one is a prince, but it's more complex and nuanced than that, and it already shows you the complexities in the story's future, which is something that I very much enjoyed. Because if you didn't get it from the synopsis, we are looking at the story from the bad guy's, well, the villain's point of view. The man who's going to be executed. The typical fantasy adventure story of father being killed and taking back one's kingdom has already passed. This is the after effect. And it's also the first non-isekai story that I've read in which our hero gets killed in the first chapter. Don't worry, it gets better though. But yeah, he dies in the first chapter, like gets his head chopped off. And rather than going to some copy and paste Dragon Quest world clone, He is sent back to the past. Samurai Bart. Yeah, but really, he's sent back to the past after dying. Which is, you know, pretty cool. A pretty cool premise. And the story, thanks to this, carries a lot of suspense with it. And trust me, it will keep you at the edge of your seat as you uncover what really happened in the past. And also the suspense to the fall of the Axis Kingdom. Like, that was what I really enjoyed. And also, I know I haven't mentioned this, but the protagonist of our story isn't your typical fantasy protagonist. I mean, look-wise. Like, you're probably expecting your dashing rogue hero who looks like he stepped out of a swimsuit model magazine. But this guy is, he's not conventionally attractive, that I will say. Like, he's not your typical hero from the position that he's in the story. All of that stuff, which is very much what I've enjoyed from this. Like, I'm a huge fantasy fan, and I'm very happy when I see fantasy stories that don't fall into the traps of the typical fantasy trap. Which isn't to say that I don't enjoy my typical fantasy stories, it's just that I've always felt that with fantasy you can do a lot with it. And yeah, this has been Red Chaos 1, signing off.